But the title of my sermon is Created, Called, and Crowned. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. First and foremost, I want to address every woman here that is finding Mother's Day difficult. Perhaps you are here under the sound of my voice this morning. You don't have a relationship with your mom, or you've lost your mom. You feel like you don't have your own biological children, or there's just something about Mother's Day that brings some memory to your heart and you find it very difficult, even though it is meant to be a time of celebration. I want to tell you this morning that the balm of Gilead is in the house. Jesus, the healer that we believe in, is in the house. No matter what the cause of your pain is, he will heal you. He will settle you in the mighty name of Jesus. John chapter 16, verse 21. The scripture says, a woman, when she's in travail, hath sorrow because her hour is come. But as soon as she's delivered of the child, she remembereth no more the anguish for joy that a man is born into the world. Amen. The truth is that as God has purpose for chairs, for pencils, for the microphone that I'm holding, for anything that God has created, God has purpose for women. Praise the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. And so God created every woman with a purpose in mind, and he called every woman with a purpose, and he crowned every woman with the resources to fulfill that purpose. The call to motherhood is a call to suffer. That scripture says when a woman is in travail, she has sorrow because her hour is come. From where I come from, when women want to give birth to babies, people, or after women have given birth to babies, people say, I'm trying to translate it in English. They say that it's almost like saying, thank God you survived through the valley of the shadow of death. That's the closest way I can describe it. And so when children are born, women suffer. Even after they are born, women continue to suffer. The scripture even says in Proverbs chapter 10, verse 1, it says, a wise son makes a father glad, but a foolish son is a grief to his mother. And so we see that the call to motherhood is such a great call that comes with a lot of responsibilities. But the good news is that God has crowned every one of us with the resources to fulfill that role. And I pray that you will not fail in Jesus' name. Isaiah chapter 49, verse 15. What does God say about a mother? The Bible says, can a woman forget a sucking child? Remember, we just read about how a woman suffers and travails. That scripture says, can a woman forget her sucking child, that she should not have compassion on the son of her womb? Yea, they may forget, yet will I not forget thee. Praise the Lord. On this note, I want to address certain categories of women. If you are here this morning, perhaps you have a mother that has forgotten you and you are hurting, I want to tell you that the mother of all mothers is here to take you up. Praise the Lord. Because the Bible says in Psalm 27 that if my father and my mother forsake me, the Lord will take me up. I know that God is able to heal your heart in Jesus' name. There was a time that the prophet Jeremiah had some issues, and he was lamenting in the book of Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 17. He was saying that, why didn't he die in his mother's womb? Why did his mother's womb not become a grave for him? For you to have given birth to that child, and that child did not die in your womb, that your womb did not become a grave for that child, I bring you good news this morning. The God that allowed you to birth that child will give you every grace you need so that you do not give up in the mighty name of Jesus. And there's yet another category of people. It is the mother that is saying this morning, Lord, you see my heart. I'm doing everything that I know how to do as a mother. But I'm telling you, I am weary. This mothering thing is just too much for me. You are here, you need strength. The strength of Israel will hold you up. in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm still talking about a mother does not forget. Who is a mother? A mother is that one that does not forget their suckling child. Maybe you are here this morning and you are saying, well, according to the definition of who a mother is, I have not carried a child of my own. I want to tell you, the word of God says none will be barren in the land. Your time is coming in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's give the Lord a round of applause. So who is a mother? A mother teaches. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 20. The Bible says, my son, keep your father's commandment and forsake not your mother's teaching. Many of us can truly say, as we are seated here, my mom taught me this, my mom taught me that, my mom taught me this, my mom taught me that. But we need to revisit how we are teaching our children in this age and time, especially for those of us in the Western world. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Many of us are leaving the teaching to the schools, to the daycare, to Sunday school teachers, to the junior church and all of that. The Bible says, my son, keep thy father's commandment and forsake not the law of your mother. Another translation calls it, and forsake not your mother's teaching. I pray that we will not fail in this duty in the name of Jesus, because there is no way we can teach what we don't know. The Bible talks about Timothy. It talks about the faith that was forced in his grandmother and then in his mother. To teach faith, you have to have faith. To teach someone how to cook, you have to know how to cook. I'm beseeching you in the name of Jesus, please and please, as we continue to fulfill this call, we have been created, we have been called, we have been crowned. I pray that we will not be weary in well-doing in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs chapter 29, verse 15, it says, the rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself brings shame to who? Mothers don't want to answer me. Let us read it again. I didn't write Proverbs. The rod and reproof give wisdom, but a child left to himself bringeth. It is the mothers that come to shame. Please, the Lord will strengthen you. You will not be weary in the mighty name of Jesus. Who is a mother? A mother is that one that comforts. This is the expectation of God for a mother. Isaiah 66 verse 13 tells us that as one womb is mother comfort, so I will comfort you. You shall be comforted in Jerusalem. The expectation of God for a mother is to comfort. You are not supposed to give up. Again, who is a mother? A mother lives by faith. A mother does not give up. You cannot give up on your children. The Bible tells us in 2 Kings chapter 4 verse 30, it talks about the mother of the child. It says, as the Lord lives and as you yourself, I would not leave. There's a story there. And it's very important that the Shunammite woman was mentioned. But we don't even have a full name. But in that story, she met the prophet Elisha on one of her visits. And she didn't have a child. And then all of a sudden, he prayed for her. She had a child. And then guess what? The child died. This woman did not give up. She was a woman of faith. Many times as mothers, we literally have to exercise our faith to push our children through. You have to live by faith. You have to be an example of faith to your children. You are not supposed to be that person that will crumble in their presence. I know it's difficult. I know it's not very easy. But we have to continue to live by faith. And God will give us grace in the name of Jesus. Who is a mother? A mother protects. Praise the Lord. A mother protects. You are not just protecting physically. You are protecting emotionally. You are protecting from all the arrows that are flying by day and by night. In this country that we live in, there are diverse kinds of arrows. I watch the children in schools and I see that God Almighty, you are the only one that can keep a child in this environment. A mother protects. Exodus chapter 2 from verse 1 to 2 talks about the story of Jochebed, the mother of Moses. Even when the situation was difficult, when they had been commanded that they should go and kill all male children, she did not give up on her child. She protected him and she hid him for 3 months. Do you know what it takes to hide a baby? How will you do that? The moment that the baby will cry, you will do shh, put a cloth all over the baby's mouth. But she protected this baby because she saw what man could not see. She saw the future of this baby. No matter what situation our children are currently going through now, the Lord expects us to protect them. Protect them in prayers. Protect them physically. Protect them emotionally. Protect them from the things they see. Protect them from the things that they hear. Praise the Lord. We are living in the end times. The Bible says in the latter times, there will be a lot of evil. And there is just very little you can do. You cannot be with them every time. So the most you can do is to cover them in prayers. And let them know you are praying. Let them know that your heart is following them. Let them know that the Spirit of God on the inside of you is accompanying them. If you tell them don't do this, they are so technologically inclined that before you know it, they are looking at things they shouldn't be looking at. It is your job to protect. If Jochebed could protect Moses from the authorities in Egypt at that time and kept him for 3 months, when they were going to kill him if they saw him, then we don't have any excuse not to protect. You protect in prayers. If you see or notice anything that does not seem right, be praying to God. Physically, you have to protect them. Many questions that come is because they want to know. It's not because they are being nosy. It is safer for you to find answers for them at their level than for you to say, keep quiet. Don't talk about that. Because they are going to go to school and they are going to talk with their friends. Praise the Lord. So our duty as mothers is to protect. And I pray that the Lord will give us grace in the mighty name of Jesus. A mother is also very courageous because this Jochebed, the mother of Moses, was very courageous according to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23. The scripture says that they were not afraid of the king's commandment. It says by faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents. Let's say it was just the doing of his father. The scripture will not say parent. So, and if you read Genesis very well, you will know that it was the mother that orchestrated the plan. It says because they saw that it was a proper child and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. Please, we are living in a nation where there are so many rules and regulations and we have a tendency to be afraid of the verdict of the authority. But don't, because of that, allow your children to slip away from the law of God. A mother blesses. Praise the Lord. It is the heart cry of a mother to bless. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 14. Paul was saying something to the Corinthian Christians. I want us to look at it together. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 14. He says, here for the third time, I am ready to come to you, and I will not be a burden, for I seek not what is yours but you. For children are not obligated to save up for their parents, but parents for their children. Let me read it in the King James Version. Behold, the third time I am ready to come to you. This was Paul speaking to the Corinthian Christians. He said, and I will not be burdensome to you, for I seek not yours but you. For the children ought not to lay up for the parents, but the parents for the children. This is kind of talking about material blessing. The expectation of God is that a righteous man will leave an inheritance for his children's children. Don't use your children as a source of income. Be very careful because you are not fulfilling scriptures. The scripture says that you are to lay up for your children. Not your children laying up for you. But that's not really where I'm going. I wanted to talk about spiritual blessings. But if you look at the scripture literally, Paul was trying to remind the Corinthians Christians that, look, even though I'm coming, I'm not going to be a burden to you. As a parent, do not be a burden to your children. The children have their own commandment from God. They are to honor their father and their mother. They know what to do to honor you as a parent. But do not be a burden to them. But like I said, that's not where I'm going. You know, as a parent, you have to have a word of blessing in your mouth. I'm talking about spiritual blessing. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 19, the Bible talks about how after Anna had prayed and eventually God gave her Samuel. The Bible says that God gave her Samson. The Bible says that every year whenever she went up, she always took a robe to him each year. She always gave him something. As a parent, you should give blessings to your children. Praise the Lord. When you see a man that is standing strong, know that God has allowed the parents to pronounce blessings upon them. Don't say negative things about your children. That is part of blessing them. Have a word of blessing in your mouth. But what I'm saying is that you have to have a word of blessing. Your children might not be where you want them to be right now, but do not pronounce curses and add to their problems. Let your mouth speak blessings. Amen. Amen. So a mother is courageous. A mother blesses. A mother protects. A mother should live by faith and not give up. A mother comforts. And a mother teaches. And of course, a mother does not give up. A mother does not forget his or her child. Praise the Lord. And the Lord will not forget any one of us in Jesus' name. In conclusion, a mother prays. We all know the story of Hannah. She prayed until God gave her her son. As a mother, you have to continue to pray. But my question to you this morning is that, who is your mother? As a child of God, you have a biological mother as well as mothers in faith. In Matthew chapter 12, starting from verse 48 to 50, Jesus was talking to his disciples. Matthew chapter 12 from verse 48 to 50. Matthew chapter 12, verse 48 to 50. But he replied to the man who told him, "Who is my mother and who are my brothers?" But he answered and said unto him that told him, "Who is my mother and who are my brethren?" Verse 49. I want to read from the King James Version. And he stretched forth his hands towards his disciples and said, "Behold my mother and my brethren." Verse 50. "For whosoever shall do the will of my Father which is in heaven, the same is my brother and sister and mother." What am I saying? The scripture is saying that your mother is anyone that is doing the will of God. We live in an age where people can no longer be corrected in the church of God. We live in an age where people can no longer be told when they are dressing indecently. Your mother is anyone that does the will of God. And if they correct you, it behooves on you to take the correction in love. The scripture even says in the book of Titus chapter 2, if you read from verse 1 to 15, it says older women are to teach the younger women to love their husbands and their children, to be self-controlled, pure, working at home, kind and submissive to their own husbands, so that the word of God may not be reviled. Many times in the church of God, people don't see others that are older in the faith as their mothers. They don't see others that are even older by age as their mothers. And they don't want to take instruction. Your mother does not have to be your mother that is in Ikpetu Ijesha, in somewhere in Nigeria. Your mother is anyone that does the will of God. And so again, I want to address the fact that mothers deserve honor. Because the Bible even recognizes that. And that is why today, again, I want to say Happy Mother's Day to everyone. And again, I will not leave out those that are finding Mother's Day difficult. You know, at times you get carried away. You just talk, you talk, you talk, you talk. You don't know that neighbor that is next to you. I mean, if someone does not have a husband, as we speak, as we are here, if that individual is a widow and she has a toddler, who is going to teach that toddler to tell that mom Happy Mother's Day? Because we're so insensitive. At times we get carried away. As much as we're celebrating Mother's Day, there are some people that are finding today very difficult. I know of people that are tongue-talking, fire-spitting, have churches, and they do not have children of their own. But I know one thing, that there is a God in heaven that sees every pain and is able to heal every hurt. But as we celebrate Mother's Day, let us be conscious of some of these things. Let us not give up on our role. We have been created. We have been called. And above all, we have been crowned. We have been crowned to open our eyes to see. Please let us not be blind to other people's pain. Let us not be blind to other people's weaknesses. The Lord will help us in the mighty name of Jesus.